Okay, this is the beginning of my sacred walk at Glastonbury. This is my place of Perth Road, just around here. And what I normally say is as if I was doing my normal walk. So I go, Peoth, Perth Road. I open my arms, I open my mind, I open my heart, and I fall into the cauldron of Kudawedin. And then up the hill I go. And you may hear me panting. Sorry about the bells. But the camera is tied to my shaman stick. So just imagine you're riding a caribou. It's going to be quite exciting. But it is a long walk. And I will be getting out of breath because this is a steep hill. And it's been a while since I did this. When I lived here before, I did it every day. I've done it pretty much every day since I've been back, even with a bad back and a bad neck, but I always suffer afterwards. But today, I'm doing it, and this is Saturday, 2nd of October, or 3rd of October, not sure, but it's October. And this is actually my favourite month of the year. The leaves are beginning to change, the mists of Avalon are beginning to stir. And forgive me if I swear, because it's normal, normally my mode of language. Not being offensive, just where I come from. And for those who have read my book will understand the place I'm coming to now, just at the bridge of this hill, is where I met Odin's wife. So for me, this is the place of Burkan. Oh. And it's from there all the way around to there. And she came from this direction along the path towards me. Burkan. Burkan, Burkan. So onwards and upwards. Good news is it just does level off out here for a while. Now we're coming up to the place of Urad, the Hern Tree, which is where I received my first initiation in Glastonbury. Spiritually, when I was drumming the drums and chanting and going on vision with my two friends, Gary and Tim. You can't really see the tree in its full form at the moment because it's green and lush with leaves. But as the winter comes on, there are two swooping boughs that look like the horns of the auroch. And normally I don't go down to it. I stay on this path and I give my prayers to it. Oh, sorry. My nose is beginning to run now as well. Okay. So let's sit there, the big one in the middle. Urazu. Uraz. Urazu. Mighty Uruk that led me on my way, give me strength and energy on my path ahead. Thank you. And all of these places, those particular runes I left at that spot. It is good to be back. Slowly settling in, coming acclimatized. Now working regularly in yin and yang. Old clients are coming to see me. I do need to do more of that. I'm keeping up to date with all my clients from America who I love dearly, but I need to reconnect with my British clients. I will give you a brief explanation of why each rune place resonates with the rune that I left there. And I have no idea if the camera's pointing on the road or not. I can't really see the back of the screen. Hold up. Seems to have gone black. Or it's still recording, I don't know. I'm just going to stop it for a minute, hang on. Alright. So it hasn't been recording. Okay, cool. Or is it just stopping? Well, we'll keep it going. See what I get. See how it comes out. It'll be a test. It turns itself over for a certain time. Who knows? I could have been talking to myself for the last 10 minutes. It's the age of technology. And even though I follow the way of the ancestors, and I try to keep them as pure and positive as I can, I have to honour the age that I was born in, with the tools that are gifted to me in my time, especially the internet, because I connect with people all over the world. And I know that it doesn't seem right, but it's the tools of my age. And it's a powerful tool. It's like a different dimension, just like Frithgarth, the world between worlds. And the internet is a world all on its own, where we can do medicine, magic, and achieve great things. We're working together with positive thought, energy, prayer, and medicine. So there's a tour. A few people up there already. Even that's early. About 7:30. It's not that early, I suppose. So I'm going to crouch down here because there's leaves on the trees. So this is my place of tearways, where I see all the warriors from my line back to the beginning, and I take my place in there. Tearways, my brothers, I see you, and I await to take my place in the shield wall of time. I know that you eagerly await me, and I will be there and become part of the wall. Bless you all. I'm just doing this again. Yeah, it is still running, that's pretty good. Okay, so this is the fairy lane. I passed several ghosts here early in the morning thinking there were people turning and there's nobody there. And they probably thought the same of me. May have been a ghost, may have been a glitch in time. And we look through there. We can just about, here boy. There's a gypsy pony in there. Should be another one here. Anyone say hello? Hello boy. Come on. They're eating, what are they eating? Hazel trees. Alright, have a good day. Anyways. This is one of my favourite places in Glastonbury. Got a magical, magical feel. Right, so the next one up here is my place of fae, which is the entrance to the fairy realm. Doesn't look much, but it is like a doorway in the hedge. You want to pass through there. I was gifted my Thor's hammer. So, this is the gateway to Vanaheim. And if you can make it out just there, and you notice that there's no wire across it, you can walk straight through. Holy place. Feyu, Feyu, Feyu. I stand before the entrance to the fairy realm. I give thanks to Freya and Frey. To Gwynat, Nidh, and Craigieland. Bless you all. May you bless me on my day ahead. For you. On we go. Hopefully the camera is still pointing in the same direction. My arm is now beginning to cramp, stuck in that position, but these are the things I do to get the right effect. So this is the Now These field, or the Christ field it's known as in Glastonbury. this field here, along this path across the centre, I don't know if you can just see it in the grass, this is where most people have encountered Christ. But halfway up there, over to the right, is where I was poisoned by a witch doctor who wanted to initiate me. So it is where my old self was died and my new self was born, with faith in my shamanic path. So for me, it's the place of now these, of letting go, cutting the ties from the past. Now these. I don't even know if the camera can hear my voice because the microphone's in the front, and due to my skin flintishness, I brought the most poxiest camera I could buy. Who needs a GoPro when I can get one for 20 quid? But you pay for what you get is what you pay for. So I'm hoping it comes out. I'm having to speak louder than normal so it's heard. Probably the bells are interrupting a bit. And if we pass anyone, they'll think I'm start raving mad. But most people think that anyway, so I'll change a habit of a lifetime. So on we go. My path takes us all around the edge of the tour, and if you can see, if you look at the tour now, the ridges from above, that is the labyrinth. That is a sacred walk. I'm never going to film that because you walk in the labyrinth, unwinding the doorways of your mind until you get to the very center. Then you sit there and you think of all the things you're supposed to realize and what wisdom, spirits and gods want to give you. And then you come back out the same way, closing every doorway. That's a day's walk on its own, and very spiritual and not to be filmed. Maybe one day you'll walk that with me, who knows. Check for traffic. Traffic, no traffic. Okay, on we go. For me, there's something special about these country lanes this time of the morning. I'll pass a couple of people, maybe dog walkers I used to know. There's a lamb, a sheep with a cough. Interesting. If any of you know the shamanic meaning of a coughing sheep, please get in touch, because I don't. Here's the back way of the tour, and if you look at the tour now, there's a few people up there along with a few sheep. They'll be doing prayers. This is one of the gateways on the tour. To me, this side of the tour is pretty dark energy. So you go there at specific times, when you're invited or when you're told by spirit to go. If you go when you're not invited, be ready for a surprise or to be kicked off the tour and chased out of there by the shades. We each have to know where we're allowed to go and where we're not, where we're welcome and where we're not. They know I exist, I know they exist. And we exist in a sort of uneasy truce. And that's the way it should always be. For those out there who believe in just love and peace all the time, from my experience in the world as general and the world of spirit, there is always war in factions. There always has been. There always will be. Somebody even needs to have the upper hand. Somebody wants power over somebody else, because power corrupts and we all crave it. It's only when you've had it and it didn't bring happiness, you can let go of it and realize there's a greater path. But then you need to help those who are struggling with it. Well, now I'm warming up now, trying to undo a few buttons. Can't remember if these two yellow lines in America are the same as Britain. Basically means do not park. As you can see, the size of the road, not particularly big, so that makes sense. Plus why they dump the rocks here, because you get the new age travellers and the van people parking up living here. So they dump the rocks so they can't do it. Well, I may be one of them soon. Who knows? I'm thinking about getting a motorhome so me and Tim can go out to different places. I'll have somewhere to live and keep my stuff, and we can go down to different venues and do our videos and recording, feeling the energies of sacred sites, having a crack. It will be like this, you know. This is the reason the bells are on it, because I have a shaman stick selfie. I'm using my sacred stick with the camera on it. I thought it would give it extra added energy and maybe add to the whole process. We'll see. And here you go. So the first car that's parked illegally. Now, if you can see, this is a farm road. If a big tractor and trailer want to come by, they are going to struggle. Seems strange when there is only just a lay-by just about 5 yards in front of them. I think might be people sitting in them, so they can always move if a vehicle comes. I'm beginning to sound very old. This is the sort of thing I would never contemplate when I was a kid. Comes with age, I suppose. Nobody in it. Okay. So this says disabled only, so only disabled people can park here. But it is slightly wider. So if you aren't going to park here, park here. Okay, this place now is, it's called the Pot of Gold Field. Something to do with rainbows. But for me, there's a sort of quick glimpse of all the things they say about the tour. Mostly this is all about the Christian path. Doesn't really mention the pagan path at all. But, because the tour was here before they built a church on top of it. As I've said in my other videos. So this is the Pot of Gold Field. This is the field where I first encountered Odin in Glastonbury. And he came upon me riding on Sleipner, right up before me, and I was like a child. And I walked beside him. So before I enter any further, Odin, Othella, Othella. Odin, I enter the tour this day to give prayers and thanks, give offerings for the birds, and also to record for those who can't be here to understand the path they walk. Bless you. More sheep. Okay. And you can see the sheep on one of the terraces that go around the tour. Filming. Oh, this ain't right. Okay, it's going to be what it's going to be. It says I've been filming 3 minutes. I've probably been walking 15 minutes. Who knows what's going to happen? It is recording. It is recording. That might have only been 3 minutes. Who knows? Seems longer. Probably does to you watching as well. Never mind. Okay, this is my place of Io, which is quite sad because Io is the rune of focus, and this is a ford between the two fields. So this is actually the ford of focus, which is really sad. Io, Io, Io. Bless you. So onwards and upwards again. I've said that once. Once that again. So we're coming to the gateway now. As you can see, the orchards of Avalon are just there, another sacred place. This is the gateway into the actual tour itself. This tree, there was a tree there can see where it's been cut down. That was my tree of Yara. But I still say the prayer. Yara, Yara, Yara. I come home to do my work. And I accept the task put before me. Thank you. Now you're going to come to a place where three runes were dropped in very close succession. But I can no longer walk that way. Since I was last here, trees have fallen down and that pathway is blocked. So I have to say to Odin, it's time for me to walk a different path, which you've agreed upon. Even this wasn't here. So I come this way. I have to watch out for sheep shit as well. By my French. This is my place of Giba, where I make my oaths. And I look, there you go. I look for Giba in the branches of trees. Gibo, Gifu, Gafen. Okay, here is where I made my oaths. Drew my own blood into the ground to honor the gifts that Spirit has given me. Thank you. Now I go. Now I'd normally walk straight through that. But as you can see, the tree's fallen down. There's brambles and stingers there now. So now that pathway is closed. So I'm walking a different way. And there's a big... See the crow in the tree? He knows I'm off my path. So I will cut back in. Because the place there is very important. Okay. So I would have come through there. But as you can see, so this is my place of Ansu's, there to speak the word of Onin and honour his path, to listen to his wisdom, to guide others with his words. Ansu's, Ansu's, Ansu's. I spit there always, part of me giving back to the tour. Yeah, that's a gypsy thing. Some people find it offensive. We spit on your hand when you make a deal. It's an oath, a promise. And this here, this bush and this branch hanging down, is where I left the Hagel rune, because it's delayed, the place of Hemdal. The gatekeeper stops me here. And this is Hemdal and Suez Giba, which actually spells the word hag. And this is the place of the three crones, or the Norns. This is where they dwell, for me, for other people somewhere else. So. Hegelizes, Hegelizes, Hegelizes. Hemdal. Let me free when I'm free. Let me go when I'm go. And I've just been told something, that I have to turn the camera off just for a few moments because the next three runes can't be shown. Thank you. Okay, now we're back on the path again, isn't it? If anyone knows Glastonbury too, I'm now going back on myself. It's a really important thing when you work with the lands anywhere in the world. You ask the land whites for permission. You ask the question, and you wait for the permission. And if permission isn't given, then you don't go there. It's called respect and honouring the land. Today, there were three runes that I couldn't show you. Not supposed to. It's not supposed to be filmed or recorded. Maybe one day he'll come and do this walk with me, but you weren't meant to go there today. This is somewhere that came on my path. It's not a rune, it's a bind rune. It's a tree that I handed guardianship over to when I left, and it was just a small tree then. It's grown to be good and strong, and it's white and it's beautiful, and I call it Nithvan, and I thank you for my brother for working hard, and give honour and respects for the work you've done. I'm spitting again, sorry. down the bank here, which is quite precarious, as I nearly fell just then. And this is where my back and neck really start to hurt. But this is work I do for spirit, so I will tolerate them, because that's what I have to do. And this plant is, green plant, is stinging nettle. It is the plant of muspelheim. But normally where you find stinging nettle grow, which burns, and it's very protective and very healing, and if it's trying to keep an area sacred, they'll grow and keep it. But also down there, this is dock leaf, and that's the antidote for stinging nettle. So they're always handy, nature always provides in one way or another. So we're walking back then, hopefully you can see this path, I don't know what you're seeing on the camera. So this is the tree that I have the most connection with in this whole valley, the whole Vale of Avalon, and it is this one. I actually don't even know what tree it is. If any of you watching this video can tell me, I'd really appreciate it. I'll show you the leaf. This is my brother. This is the Thor tree, aged and wise but strong and always there for me. Hey old brother, I've come to say thanks this day. Come to connect with you and give you healing and receive healing in return. Thoraz. My brother Thor tree, I honour you the days of my life. Bless you. Now we have to sort of, it's important we go this way. As I just told you about stinging nettles, we're having quite a load. This is lively. Okay. As you can see, through that path, not many people go, probably me and the sheep. As we come down, you can see the well-beaten path where everyone goes. But I will stop here. I'm going to, there's still over there, there's different places. But this is a place of Rado. 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 May the wheel turn and take me on my journeys. May it guide me on the path I am meant to walk. For the road ahead is unknown, and I like the fact it is unknown. I do not know what is around each corner, so always keep me surprised. Thank you. And then this place here, in this woods and beyond, is my place of the fairies, Ingaz. It's a bit getting to October time, beginning a little bit, it's normally lush and abundant. Ingazu, Ingazu, Ingazu. I have to share some offerings here, some bread. Oh, it's already jumped out of the bag, it was meant to be. Now this is, hopefully I don't get done by the stingers as I bend down. Pavalunda, king of elves. See the squirrel on the branch? Maybe you can see that. Ingi Frey, Famigia de Tiennog, for the whites of this place, for the fairies of this glen and the elves of the wood, for the shades that dwell here, I give offerings this day. For the brotherhood of the golden dragon who watch over me in my life, I thank you all. The crows, the badgers, the wolves, the gull and the caribou, I share my feast with you. And the tree is beginning to turn. That's the first one. It's an oak tree. This is a Tommy. I love this. It's wonderful. Right. Just check if I'm still filming. Yeah, into 20 seconds. God knows how that works. But hopefully I haven't deleted everything I've just done. If it is, that's the way it's meant to be. Nothing I can do about it. So, this is the path through the fairy wood. If you ever come here, you'll feel the peace and tranquility. But I advise you not to step off of the path, this path, either way, unless you know your medicine. There are some very strange forces at work in this place. glorious morning. The fog's beginning to burn off. It's getting slightly warmer. And today is a day of the witchcraft fair in Glastonbury, where all the stuff is handcrafted. So I will be going there, see if I can pick up some tools. I'm actually looking for a white fan, maybe dove, maybe pigeon. In my vision, it was white raven, but I reckon they're fairly skinny on the ground. But just to honour that creature after it's passed, and to use it for cleansing and purifying places. I had quite a strange experience in doing a video here the other day. I was asked to do it, and what I saw and what I experienced in the video and the people watching the experience was quite sort of harrowing. So that's not for public view. This is my place of Windsor, where the dragon flag flies high above. So I shake the tree. Windsor, Windsor, Windsor. Okay, here we go. Down again. So these three trees here are the maid, the mother, and the crone. There's one young one, one middle one, one old one. Can't go through there. See the stingers are coming up? They're telling you that's not the way in. That's when you go around this way. Trust what the plants are showing you. Trust what the trees are showing you. Trust what the animals show you. That brings me back to the coffin sheep. Not a clue. Okay, so I stand here. And this is my place of Issa, to be still and understand the medicine. Issa. Issa, Issa. So we turn first to the maid. I knew you once, my Lady Freya. I give thanks this day. Then we turn to the mother, the goddess Frigga. I know you now. Give me love and blessings this day, so that I may not feel alone. And there we go. The goddess Gullaveg, the crone. I will know you soon. And she is old and gnarled, and I always stop for a moment to give her some healing. Urazu. Thank you. It's interesting, there are some mushrooms growing on the tree. Slimy, snotty, I'm not sure what they are. If my wife Tara was here, she'd probably know. But she's not. And there's some interesting ones here. This is the time. The fall is the perfect time for mushrooms. Thank you, ladies. I'll see you again soon. So on we go. Following the path. Another raven. See the raven? So some people who watch this video, if you get this far, you may think that's just epoxy bit of land. But to me it's not. It is history and splendour. Passing my first dog walker of the day. Okay. Hello. Hello, bub. You need a bath when you get in?
All the muddy stuff, and she can have a bath tomorrow then. I didn't realise it was going to be quite so cold.
Oh, it's lovely.
It's nice, isn't it?
Or
well,
for walking.
Feet,
oh, yeah.
Better boots on like you have. Yeah. But the mud, it's really nice, isn't it?
Have a nice day.
I will.
We probably should edit that bit out afterwards. Something to do with copyright, I don't know. But like filming kids, you film somebody's dog, you may get done for it. Okay, so I always just speak to these trees here. My sister, watch over this land as I'm back again. What do you wish to tell me this day? Thank you. And on we go. So, the last time I was here in Beltane, not I've been here a couple of times since I've been back, but the last time I was here in Beltane, my bramble bush that burned down my place as a willow was just beginning to grow again. And there it is in front of me again, fully grown. But when I connect with it, it isn't the same, it is different. The same, but different. As we all have to change, I have been away and come back, and I am not the same. There we go. Touch it. Oh, my brother, my sacred brother, born again, resurrected before me. So. Grown within the bramble, each working on each other, symbiotic, not harming the other. But that's what bramble does, it clings but it doesn't suffocate. For me, it is a holy plant with a special meaning. If you love something, don't hold it too tightly. Bless you. So, oh my god. Okay. When I get back, I've got to download this to the computer and work out how to transfer it to a Dropbox. And then when I go online tonight with the ether lead, I've got to transfer it to the Dropbox. It's the 21st century scene. We are back to the town now. You can hear the traffic again. Okay. This is a sacred place. This is born again. So normally this is where I look out across the valley, but there's fog and mist this morning, so you can't see it. But this is my place of manas, where I've stayed many lifetimes before, chanted and done healing, fought in battles, and loved. Manas! 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 It is I. Descended from the lords of Avalon, land guardian of the sacred Tor, healer to some, oracle to others, shaman of my people, come to give thanks this day, for I have the right, for I am blood kin to none other than Odin, the All-Father. Spat again. Just a beautiful day for a walk. I don't know how long I've been walking. Probably about, well, since I left home I've been walking an hour, but I didn't start filming then. So hopefully it's got everything I wanted to record. I hope so. Who knows? Let's just check again. No, that doesn't seem right. Okay, so if this doesn't come out, it wasn't meant to. It may have to be chopped and changed 100 times, edited back together by Super Kelly, who does everything for me. She's like a gift from the gods. Changed my way I do my business, keeps me organised, and has been a good friend. Now, finally, the sun is beginning to come out behind us. Yeah. And at the moment I'm incognito, you may have got a glimpse of me there. My woolly hat, my old coat, my glasses. Nobody recognises me in town, which is good. That's the way I like it, when I'm doing my medicine. Later on I'll be out in the town with my contact lenses in, waistcoat, Larry shirt, top hat, and stand out. But that is how I work as a beacon. Some people will be drawn to me, some people will be repelled, think I'm a stupid twat for dressing like that, but they'll all notice me, and that's all I can do in the honour of Odin, is be noticed. These two trees are the gateway into the tour from the other side. For me, this is the place of Laguz, the sacred fountain of energy I pass through and I'm cleansed. And I always just pause there for a moment to give thanks for allowing me to make my walk this day, allowing me to be blessed to see the tour another day in my life. I just hung a blue bag on there, what for, I don't know, actually. Some spiritual meaning. Laguz, Laguz, Laguz. Okay. And now we come to the field of the moon stallion, to the place of Awaz, where I first lost the first rune that began this whole sacred walk of Glastonbury led by spirit. And where the moon stallion used to come to me as a child to guide me here, and where I dreamt of riding him, wearing my top hat, many, many years before I even ended up being here. So. Awaz. And I just paused for a minute. Imagine him running and prancing around the field, his mane flowing, his tail flowing, strong and noble. And I thank you all for being with me on my walk. Hopefully it's come out, and hopefully you enjoy it and you don't find it ridiculously boring. If you do, you've got to see some of the beautiful countryside of England. Bless you all.